Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Good morning, Your Excellence, dear ladies and gentlemen. It's a pleasure for me to represent Lithuania at this conference and to share with your experience of renewable energy development in Lithuania and few items, existing station, fusing renewables, national support schemes, objectives for deployment, and expectations about contribution for renewables. Of course, many factors are influencing deployment of renewables in Lithuania. Maybe first of all, because Lithuania is very dependent on import of primary energy in 2011, only 18% were local, 82% were imported from only, maybe only on source mostly. That's why directive on renewables was also fostering deployment of renewables in Lithuania, and the law on renewable energy was approved by Parliament in 2011, and the National Energy Independence Strategy approved in Parliament this year are supporting very much deployment. And current status could be represented by a few slides. First of all, what are the major sources of renewable energy in Lithuania? Then you see it's mostly biomass, but we have growing contribution from wind power plants and other sources. That indication is electricity production from renewables, which is growing rather fast during last few years and will grow in the future. Then maybe three indicators are the most important. First of all, is the contribution from renewables into gross final energy consumption, which is, you can see, growing, but maybe not so fast, but there are some positive and negative, let's say, factors. Then contribution of renewables into primary energy, which is comparatively rather high, about 15%, and contribution of renewables into gross electricity consumption. So all indicators increased rather significantly after closure of nuclear power plant in Ignalina. And maybe the most interesting is the diagram of renewable energy sources flows. And you can see how much is important the major energy source from wood and wood waste. And you can see also how this energy is used in various sectors. So technology is also important, but not in all cases. In particular, for generators up to 30 kilowatt installed capacity, we have very favorable, let's say, station. They have fixed feed-in tariffs for a period of 12 years, free grid connection and possibilities also for investment support. For generators above 50 kilowatts, there are more, let's say, more difficulties because they should have tendering for feed-in tariffs for a period of course of 12 years, which is approaching to market price. And they have, of course, also some discount for grid connection cost and comparatively limited possibilities for investment support. So, as I said, this picture is, how to say, very good demonstration how the price, in particular for solar electricity, is 10 times higher this year, let's say, than electricity market price. So then we have a so attractive price for electricity producers from solar, Permits are growing from day to day, and just now we have maybe some four or even more times higher permits than we have our objectives in legal system. But if to look in, let's say, separately, in currently we have installed capacity of solar power plants rather large compared last year, up to 30 kilowatts. We have also almost 3 megawatt in comparatively large solar power plants with capacity up to 1 megawatt. And foreseen by the law on renewables is 10. So I expect that if now any changes, we will grow much faster, and the contribution will be much larger than foreseen in the law. A similar station is with capacity in wind power plants. Currently, we have, in principle, one half of the limit which is assumed in our law. And if to look to permits, then we would have this maybe four times bigger than our expectations. But maybe, as our colleague from Latvia said, not always permits are equal to real steps. The most maybe difficult problem is related with biomass power plants. Currently, we have only 55 megawatts compared with foreseen in the law, 355. And this may be somehow a challenge for our country, because we see that in our National Renewable Action Plan, it is foreseen that 21% of electricity for renewables will be in the gross electricity consumption, and this indicator I expect will be again higher, taking into account growing contribution. And this plan, which is a national plan, also will be in reality not like this, but wind power plants I expect will grow a little more. And biomass possibly also. But the most vulnerable situation is in our district heating sector, because as you can see, 73% of fuel is natural gas, and Lithuania is very vulnerable to prices of natural gas and to, let's say, some restrictions of supply. That's why contribution should grow much faster than we have. And our expectations is that we will have 50% in 2020 from renewables, but it depends very much on how situation will be changed in our system, in particular with the support of biofuel power plants. And we have also some challenges with biofuels transports. The growth is not so very large. But if we will look in general, situation is such that we have currently in 2011, 20.4% in the gross final consumption with our target 23. So we have really good possibility to reach this goal. And I think that our objective should be currently not 23, but some 25 or even 30% in gross final energy consumption. But I agree fully with the first presentation that we have achievements, but a lot has to be done. Another one that I should also, how to say, said that ST Energia, as I know, is planning to contribute into development on CHP using biomass in Lithuania and Latvia. So I think that closer cooperation with the Baltic countries and in Nordic countries also will give for us opportunities. But in general, I agree also with previous presentations that we should more think in our, how to say, general scheme, how to provide consistent conditions, relevant to market conditions for development and rational development of renewable energy sources in Lithuania. Thank you very much.
Thank you. We have time for one very quick question. Valdur.
Valdur Lasso, Stockholm Environment Institute, Tallinn Center. Has implementation or non-implementation of the Visaginas project impact to the development of renewable energy sector in Lithuania?
I agree with you in principle, of course, if we will have a situation, how to say, uncertain, maybe currently we have a little uncertain situation, I would underline. But in principle, I would say that construction of a nuclear power plant would be not contradictory with our plans to develop renewables. Because in principle, nuclear power would be very important base source. And even in a case of construction, according to my, let's say, indications, after construction, we would have some import of electricity, even if nuclear would be construction. Because renewables currently is expected will cover about 30-40% of our electricity demand. So we should think how I will show tomorrow a little more about this problem in my presentation related with the energy efficiency. But this is exactly somehow those two options are like competitors to cover our electricity demand.
Okay, thank you.